true effect of music on prenatal development remains unknown. A loosely controlled preliminary study in the Music Educators Journal in 1985 found that babies exposed to music before birth had longer attention spans than expected for their age and imitated adult sounds better. Another small study in 1997 in Pre- and Perinatal Psychology Journal looked at babies enrolled in a program called First Start, which exposed unborn babies to musical stimulation. These babies showed better motor skills, language development, and cognitive skills from birth to 6 months than the control group of babies. However, because these studies were small and have not been repeated, the question of whether and how much music affects unborn babies remain under investigation. Choose to play music for their unborn child so that the baby can grow up to be smarter. Van de Kar, a proponent of fetal stimulation, says that parents should play music because they enjoy it, not because they're trying to make their unborn baby smarter. Van de Kar agrees that you shouldn't go out of your way to create a musical genius. That attitude can cause to push hard and set a standard that your child may never meet. Studies indicate that fetuses can hear and react to sound by moving, but no one really knows what those movements mean, because experts can't observe an unborn baby as easily as a baby that has already been born. Because this study is still under investigation, there are still some researchers that believe that music, in fact, does affect the development of the fetus. As we know, technology has become more advanced. They have come up with a few devices to be able to facilitate the deliverance of the sound waves of the music to the fetus. They're called pregnancy audio systems. Because research on this topic is in its infancy, and experts can't seem to agree on whether music is enjoyable or bothersome to fetuses, proceed cautiously. If you decide to try it, remember that moderation is key.